Is there a lot of racism in general against Latinos?
There are stereotypes. The biggest discrimination would be toward Mexican people. Because there's this big belief in this country that they're coming here to just sort of take your job and to, you know, they're here without papers.
And the truth is?
The truth is, what American wants to work $5 an hour washing dishes?
They would never.
They would never do
it.
Who wants to scrub floors in the middle of the night, you know?
What is in this country that everybody wants to melt in a way?
I was just raised here to believe you can do whatever you want. You can be anything you want. No one can stop you. If you work hard, you'll get it. And you do all those things. But there's this little but. You can do anything but. You need those numbers. You need those 9 numbers.
True.
The entire time I was in high school, I worked really hard. I got really good grades. I was trying to get a scholarship. And then when it came time to apply, I found that I couldn't get in anywhere. That was the biggest shock. I think that was the most devastating one I had out of all of them. That was the worst because it really just felt like you can't do anything. And it wasn't like I didn't want to go back. It's just, well, I had nothing to go back to. I don't know anybody back home. I don't know the language. I don't know the culture. I don't understand the culture.
So you don't consider yourself Peruvian at all?
No, but
although
I'm not.
Your mother, your father is from Peru.
When we think of American culture, we think of like television and movies and, you know, the style of clothing. And so, yes, a lot of these kids, who doesn't want those things, especially when you're growing up in school, you're exposed, you're bombarded with it 24/7, you know. I'm sure it's really hard for parents to be like, no. Doesn't matter because the kid's going to want what they want.
So this kind of bombardment makes you American as well. Big influence.
Yeah. I normally don't get along well with people from Peru. I went back when I was little. We went to visit once when I was 10. I didn't fit in, you know? It doesn't work and you don't fit.
What do you need to fit in New York?
In New York? You don't need anything to fit in New York. That's the thing. In New York, you just do because anyone can be here. It's not like you have to be... You just have to be fast.
Fast meaning what?
You have to think quick. You have to know how to navigate. You need to know how to get from one place to the other. And
the place you live is like mostly Latino, or is it mixed? Or
where I live is mostly African-American.
African-American.
How
do you fit in there?
I fit in okay. I don't make any friends, you know.
Why?
Because it's not, that's the thing about New York, you don't really make friends like that. There is no sense of community.
Mm-hmm. So you don't live together, you live next to each other.
Right.
Ma este a helyszín nem egy frontvonal vagy egy diktatúra, hanem New York.
Állítólag ez a város a multikulti mintametropolisza, mert itt békében él együtt fehér, fekete és a kettő közt mindenki.
Egy kínai-amerikai, egy ortodox zsidó és egy muzulmán imám életén keresztül próbáljuk megérteni, hogy hogyan és miért tudnak együtt élni.
Márha tényleg ilyen rózsás a helyzet.
Imák, kultúrák és sztereotípiák találkozása ma este az On The Spotban, New Yorkból.